Hello, this is Patrick with New Jersey's Outdoor Adventures YouTube channel here at a beautiful horse farm in Ocean County, New Jersey. And I met up with Cody. Cody has an awesome custom camper van conversion that he's going to give us a tour of today.
Yeah, so this is Cody from Barnesville Tiny Homes here, and I have this 2020 Ford Transit all-wheel drive. Yeah, I said all-wheel drive. I know they're hard to get your hands on. We have a 2022 brand new conversion on this vehicle. We have aftermarket wheel and tire package. We have a 2-inch lift on this van, complements a van compass. And again, this is an all-wheel drive model, so I think that's what really sets this build apart. You can get off-grid and live off-grid. We have a 10,000-pound worn winch here mounted in the bumper with a van compass upgraded bumper, so you have a hitch in the front for extra cargo. That's wireless remote controlled, by the way, too. And then we have a Cree LED light bar up on the roof, so that's like looking at the sun. It's ridiculous. You can see a camera up there too. We have four-sided cameras on this van, so you know, anywhere you're parked, if there's a disturbance at night, you're gonna feel safe. We have 20 gallons of gray water capacity here underneath the van, so just, you know, pull this little blade dump valve, maybe there's some water in there. And we have a aftermarket window, sliding, a little extra ventilation and natural light. We're big on, you know, nature in these builds. And this is your key protected water, you know, port, so you can fill up your water tanks. We have 40 gallons of fresh water capacity on this build. It's all located underneath the van, and they're on heated tank sensors, so they're thermostat controlled and whatnot. We have a Furion 50 amp shore power connection for when you're in an RV park or you have a generator hooked up to the back. In the back here, we have an aluminous spare tire carrier with a toy, you know, the Toyo AT all-terrain tires on there. We're an aluminous distributor too. Thank you, aluminous. We have a class 5 hitch here, so if you want to tow your boat to the lake or whatever behind this rig, you can do that too. And, you know, surveillance cameras everywhere, like I said, and we got LEDs on the top. Let's open this puppy up. So, a nice, clean, beautiful aluminum diamond plate, nice and rugged. And so we have right here, we have these little kayak ports, and this is just something that we found out from taking the spare tire lowering assembly out, that Ford actually has a hollow bumper here in the back, so we just couldn't bring ourselves to waste that space. So that's a perfect spot to store your, you know, generator cable or anything like that. And I keep doing that. But yeah, you can, you know, stick your hand way in there, you can store your generator cable, anything like that. And we have D-ring tie downs. You want to tie your bike or totes down or anything. These are actually hammock supports here, so you could tie off to a tree and, you know, hook your hammock up to the back. And we got clean aluminum framing under here, all black powder coated aluminum with birch plywood on it. We have a cargo light, so actually it was on already. And so you can turn that on for, you know, seeing at night, of course. We have a beautiful blue Victron power equipment here, and you know, that's wired for a completely off-grid setup. You have a Victron Lynx distribution system. We have a solar charge controller, 100 amps of alternator charging, a Victron Multi-Plus 24 volt, 3000 watt inverter with a 70 amp transfer switch that's, you know, only rated for 50. But we have a 50 amp shore power disconnect right here. We have your AC panel. We have all of your DC circuit protection and whatnot there. And we have, again, all black aluminum framing. So we wanted to, you know, we think it's important to be able to get good ventilation and obviously show off this high quality Victron equipment, but also protect it from whatever cargo you have in the back here. And so we also have the water utilities here. So we have a Seaflow accumulator tank and pump. We have a 7-gallon Bosch mini tank electric water heater. And then behind that, you can't see, there's a big lithium bank there. We have 12 volt, 200 amp hour batteries wired in series to make a 24 volt, you know, 200 amp hour bank. And over here we have custom curtains that were hemmed by a local seamstress for this van. So it kind of hides the rear door and just the, you know, cargo van feel of the build. We got this nice little decorative PVC trim up there to do that as well, the rod and whatnot. Up there we have, you can see the screen for your surveillance system, so you can see Patrick and I on camera here. I can't wait to show you the inside of this build. I think it's, you know, just as special on the outside as it is on the inside, and I just couldn't skip this outside part for you. Now we have an outlet here on the outside for, you know, if you're sitting here with your friends in chairs or whatever and you got to plug your phone in or whatnot. We have, you know, this really rugged aluminum step here. You know, it's not going to twist or fall off or anything, a mahogany, you know, step. We have hexagon tiles. We have, you know, this little cubby here in the side for, you know, you want to store your dog leash or something there. Maybe you have a dog you want to take on the road with you. Welcome to the interior space here. So we got a full-size shower here, at least in terms of RV standards. We have, you know, reclaimed barn wood, tons of custom cabinetry throughout this build. We got a vinyl interior. We have this gorgeous cedar ceiling on the roof and custom cabinetry everywhere. We have a full-size bed, or just slightly smaller than full-size bed. We have a dinette area that we'll go into a bunch more detail on. And that sort of stows away and is really clean. We got max air fans for ventilation and whatnot all throughout the build. We're gonna go into some more detail here regarding, you know, everything about this van. We have, this little custom, I got at least 2 days worth of work into this thing, but we have the interior and exterior lighting panel here. So this is passenger side lights, driver side lights, and over here we have dimmer switches for all the zone lighting. So this is the middle zone for the kitchen galley. Everything's dimmable. Then we got the light strip up on the top that changes colors. It's kind of groovy if you're into some music. That actually changes colors with music too. We've got custom cabinetry everywhere. This is something we think is really a cornerstone of our builds. And so we got this, you know, driver head cabinet here. So, and it's just high enough that even a tall driver is not going to whack their head on it. We got switching here for the light bar and for, you know, an outlet with USB ports. So down under here we got the fire extinguisher and the trash can, which nothing special there, but just, you know, worth noting. So then we got this nice size shower, and this is actually bigger than most showers in vans and tiny houses. It's a little deeper. It's a 27 inch shower instead of a 24 inch shower. We got a full size toilet in there, airhead composting toilet. The exhaust, you know, port for that is in the back there. We have, looks like the shower head fill. Got it back up there like that, so you get the full idea. We have a Spanish cedar floor grate. We have this little soap shelf and whatnot with Spanish cedar and stainless steel accents as well. We have a LED light with exhaust fan in the shower, so you can fire that up. This is a little detail that we added we thought was pretty cool. So you have extra shoulder room when you're in the shower or when you're on the toilet. You know, so it's just space we couldn't, you know, waste. We're big on that here at Barnswallow Tiny Homes, and just figure it's worth pointing out. So that was your shower tour. Now let's talk about this. So this barn wood here is really something special. It's not just something that, you know, we bought from Home Depot or, you know, whatnot. This is actually right here from Barnswallow Tiny Homes headquarters. It's a barn that we tore down. And I look for any reason I can to sneak this into my builds and, you know, make it a special part of each home that I build. You know, it's just the barn inspired my company, and we're making sure it finds its way into every build. And that's not the only spot. We have it over here as well. We have beautiful black walnut custom cabinetry, you know, cabinet faces, and got gas shocks here on all the cabinets. So it's just magnetic catches on everything, so they're not going to come flying open. You know, you got to yank on them pretty hard. On the ceiling here, we have Western red cedar here that's been clear coated. And, you know, and Ford Transits actually have a sloped ceiling, which makes it particularly interesting to work on. You know, it's not like the Mercedes or whatever has a flat ceiling. And, you know, it's harder to work on from my perspective, but I think it really makes a cool front detail. And we'll show you that when we look from the back here towards the front. And before we get too far ahead of ourselves here, I wanted to go over this. So we have this chevron pattern or whatever you want to call it. And this is all oak tongue and groove on here that, you know, we sanded the edges on. We just wanted a special flair to the base cabinet when you walk in. We have a black walnut countertop here. And this is all, you know, handmade by a local carpenter as well. We actually collaborated with Little Ledge Carpentry. And we've got a two-burner induction cooktop. We can watch that get hot together. And not for too long. But and then we have underneath here, we have a microwave air fryer convection oven combination unit. So it kind of does everything, which is, you know, critical for being an off-grid van conversion. Here we have, you know, all the drawers and everything are, you know, solid rugged plywood, you know, built to last. It's not particle board in our builds. You know, black walnut faces, and this is just something we did so that you didn't have to bang your shin on any kind of hardware or whatnot. Down here on the bottom, we have this deeper drawer. So if you got deeper pots and pans or whatever you want to store in there, we think it's important not to have all the cabinetry be the same depth and whatnot. So, you know, have versatility in your storage. This is something that's become a staple in our builds. We really love doing this notched hexagon where you bring the tile flooring into the sugar maple flooring. And when we did a schoolie build, it was kind of like that before, and it's become a staple. So under here we have, you know, plenty of storage, so you can keep your sponges or whatever here, your toothbrush and whatnot in there. So, you know, it's important for that. underneath. We got this, you know, big under storage area with a HEPFO waterless trap, so all RV quality. There's nothing to freeze or anything if you left it in freezing conditions. And over here we have this big Ravati sink, so it's got two sides to it, and one huge side and one much smaller side. So, and then we got this little black walnut, you know, cover. It is movable. You can put it to either side for a little extra counter space. You know, nice industrial faucet pull out. And up here we got a mirror in case you want to check yourself out or you want to brush your teeth in the morning or whatnot. And we have a cabinet with gas shocks on it. Notice these two are different sizes for the same reason, like making those two drawers different sizes, just more utility and then more mirror space here. Over on this side of the build now, we have the other side of the dinette. We have a closet. We managed to sneak a closet into this build. So, you know, if you want to put your suit in there or whatever, that's up to you. And then further along here, we have more upper cabinetry. I think cabinetry is really what makes this build special. You know, we wanted to have lots of storage, and not just storage, but beautiful storage. And we got a utility cabin here. This is where your security systems, hard drive and DVR and all that's kept. So it's more of just an electrical utility cabinet. We got more barn wood here. We looked for any excuse to sneak that in. We got under cabinet lighting here and with a smoked lens on it. So it's subtle but bright. And then we have the Victron Servo GX touchscreen here, so it gives us our you know, energy system readouts. So, you know, it shows us the state of our chart, you know, solar panel system for the inverter, the link shunt that just tells us our overall state of the system. And even, I got to update this, but this will have water tank sensors as well on it to tell you whether your fresh and gray water tank is empty. Up here we have more black walnut counter space. So this is, you know, a perfect little work galley if you want it to be, extra chopping space, you know, if you're cooking. We got more drawers. We got drawers everywhere. I don't think I've ever seen a van build with this many drawers in it, which I just think drawers are a better storage solution than cabinets, or, you know, just hinged cabinets. So we got drawers everywhere. And then the moment we've all been waiting for, you've been wondering what those yellow tabs are, haven't you? So we got, you know, seating here. So I'm a big guy. I'm a 270 pound guy. These are 500 pound rated drawer slides, and, you know, you see they're strong as all hell. And so that's seating for one. And we got a tabletop here, like that. And actually, it helps if you pull this one out first. This is the seat behind you. And then you can pull this out and sit down. This is seating for two. You can picture pulling up to the Grand Canyon with your cup of coffee and looking out the window. So there's that. It stows away really easy. We have this cabin here, just, you know, pots and pans, blankets, anything like that, anything big and bulky can go under there. Then we got this operable window with a sliding screen and all that in here, so a little extra ventilation while keeping the bugs out. And over on this side, this is, I think, you know, something that also makes this build special is that the size of the refrigerator. You know, we got a freezer and fridge combination. It's a residential unit, but we think it's, you know, important if you're going to live in here, you have the comforts of home. I've got this toe drawer here, which I deliberately pulled open with my toe. And just the wheel well's underneath there, so we can't waste that space, can we? Got more upper cabinet space here. So I'm getting tired of even saying we got cabinet space. We got cabinet space everywhere. And then I'm going to pull this open, and I'm going to let the gas shock take it. Boom, look at that. And that's actually a side window insulated cover I just stored in there for the passenger sliding door. The bed's a full-size bed, or just under full size, because, you know, the van's a little, you know, narrower than a full-size bed, and then the depth is a little bit different. So it's 72 by 52, but takes full-size sheets. And so the head area is up here where the pillows are. And so it's kind of set up for his and hers setup. So, you know, a couple ideally would, you know, be sharing the space. And on that side, we have USB port, you know, outlet for phone charging and whatnot, with a little phone shelf to that side, and then a symmetrical phone shelf on this side. And underneath here we have you know, another USB, you know, port outlet here, so his and her side charging for whatever you want, so you don't have to crawl across each other to charge anything. And then the bed is actually on a three-way switch, so it's able to be, you know, turned off back here or from up front, and the dimmer is actually up front. But, you know, you have three zones in this build. So you have your bed light, you have your kitchen light, and then you have your entryway light. So, you know, it's not all connected. You can kind of create a mood if you want. Thanks for following along, everybody. I appreciate you checking out this build. And, you know, it'll be on Facebook and Instagram, or is on Facebook and Instagram. It's currently for sale. We encourage you, whether you're interested or not in buying it, we encourage you to check it out and like, share, comment, and, you know, follow along for future builds. This is just the first of many barn swallows to leave this nest. And I'd like to provide a little more insight on that. So, you know, this company, Born Swallow Tiny Homes, is inspired by actual birds that come to my farm every year. You know, they have their young here, they have their babies here, they're hatched, they leave the nest. And so I want every build to serve as a metaphor for a baby barn swallow that's hatched here, leaves here, and travels the world. We just thought that you'd appreciate that story, and, you know, thank you so much.
Cody, thank you very much for taking the time today to give us a tour of your awesome creation. There is things in here that I've never seen in some other van builds before, and I'm truly impressed. You have top-notch electronics. The quality of the cabinetry is unbelievable. And we talked off camera a little bit about, like, the amount of time it takes to think it up and design it versus build it probably equated. It took just as long to figure out where you want to put everything, find the parts, as much as it putting it together. And you did an excellent job. And I can't wait to have you back on the channel again for your next build.
Thank you, Patrick.
This is Patrick in New Jersey's Outdoor Adventures YouTube channel. Thanks for joining us today.